Hi friends, I am Anita HV, Department of Computer Science, Kottureshwara College, Kottur. Today let us discuss about the topic binary tree representation in data structure.
I already told that today we discuss about the binary tree representation. We already discussed about the binary tree. Now how we are representing the binary tree representation? Here we are representing the binary tree in two ways, that is linked list representation and arrays representation. First, one by one we study about the array representation. That is, first one is linked list representation. The basic component to be represented in a binary tree is a node. It consists of a three fields, that is left child, data and right child field. It means one node consists of a three fields. These fields, first is left child, next data, next right child. It means in the left child we are storing the left child information, in the data we are storing the data information, and we are storing the right child information in the right child field. First, in linked list, how we are representing the trees in the linked list representation? Here, for example, we are created the binary tree, that is A, B, C, D, E, F, G. To the corresponding this binary tree, we are representing using linked list. It means I already told that the linked list representation are, it contains a three fields, left data field and right child field. Here first node is the root node, that is A. We are storing in the first, that is a root node. Here left tree, here right tree. Next is the B. B is the left subtree of the root node A. So we are storing that. Next is B, here left subtree of the B, here right subtree of the B. Again B contains two child nodes, that is left child and right child. Here B is the, D is the left child of the B and E is the right child of the B. So we are representing. Next, D has no any child nodes and E has no any child nodes. So we are representing D left subtree is a null and right subtree is a null. Next, we are representing the right subtree of the root A, that is C. We are representing the C here. Here left subtree of C is F and right subtree of C is G. So we are representing here F and G. But again you see that F has no left subtree and right subtree, and again G has no left subtree and right subtree. So these represent as a null. So this is representation of linked list. Next, we discuss about the array representation of the binary tree. We are already discussed about the array representation. That is, here a example of a binary tree, that is A, B, C, D, E and E, F, G. Here A is the root node, it is represented at the position 0, and B is the left child of the A, it is present at the position 1, and C is the right child of the A, it represented at the position 2. Similarly, D is the left child of the B, so it presented at the third position. E is the right child of the B, it is represented at the fourth position. Similarly, F is the left child of the C, it represented at the fifth position. And G is the right child of the C, it represented at the sixth position. So we are using array representation, we have to use the single dimensional arrays to represent the position of the binary tree. So it starts from 0, 0. At the 0th position, we have the root node, that is A. We are representing here A. Next, second is, that is first position, that is B, we are representing B. Next, second is C, so we are representing C. Similarly, third position is D, fourth position is E, fifth position is F, sixth position is G. Similarly, we are representing the arrays in binary trees. I hope friends you are well known about the binary tree representation, that is two representation, linked list representation and arrays representation. Next topic, that is operations on the binary tree. It means what are the operations we are performing on the binary tree. Now we will study about this operation. First operation is create. It means this operation is used to create an empty binary tree, that is called as a create operation. Next, second is make binary tree. It creates a new binary tree having single node with data field set to some values. It means we are creating the binary tree, new binary tree, that will be set to the some values. Next is left child. It returns a pointer to the left child of the node. Next, right child. It returns the pointer to the right child of the node. Next, father. It returns a pointer to the father of the node. Sixth is siblings. It returns a pointer to the brother of the node. Next is data. It returns the content of the node. It means it gives the data of the node. Eighth is tree traversal. Ninth is insertion of nodes. Tenth is deletion of nodes. 11th one is searching for a node, and so on. Now let us discuss about the traversal of a binary tree. It is a very very important concept friends, traversal of a binary tree. What is meant by traversal or traversing? Here traversal means we are visiting each node at least once. There are three popular ways of binary tree traversal. Here traversal means, for example, here we have a tree, that is C. Here we have a tree, that is A, B, C, D, E. Here we have to visit the each node, or we have to process the each node at least one time. Andre illi navu ondu time madru navu en madbeku prati ondu node annu navu reach madbeku athva visit madbeku enakke andre to process some operations on the node. So first we have to visit A, next B, next D, next E, next C. In any other ways, yavadadru way alli kuda navu en madbeku e nodes na navu at least one time adru navu en madbeku ella nodes annu navu visit madbeku. Idike navu tree traversal anta karitivi. So in this tree traversal there are mainly three types of tree traversal, that is pre-order traversal, in-order traversal and post-order traversal. Let us discuss about one by one. That is, first is pre-order tree traversal. Here N, L, R. N represents the root node, L represents the left node, R represents the right node. Here in pre-order traversal we have the process, that is first process is we have to visit to the root node. First we have to visit the root node. Second is the visit the left subtree in pre-order manner. It means we have to first visit root node. Next process is we have to visit the left subtree in pre-order manner only. It means it contains first root node, next left, next right child. So in pre-order manner only we have to visit the left subtree. Next third point is, that is visit the right subtree in pre-order manner. It means we have to visit the right subtree again in the pre-order manner. Let us see this example, that is we have contains three nodes A, B, C. Here A is the root node and B is the left child of the root node A, C is the right child of the root node A. So how we are traversal using the pre-order traversal? That is, first is the root node. That is, root node here is A. We have to write that is, first is A. Next is left child. That is, left child means here we have B. So, we have write the B. Again, there is no nodes for the child, that is B. So, now we have to process the right child, that is C. Write the right child, that is C. This is the pre-order traversal for this binary tree, that is A, B, C. Let us see next example, that is A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Here we have 7 nodes. See, here first is the, we have to travel, visit to the first root node, that is A. We have write on that is A. Next is the left child in the pre-order manner only, that is left child is here B. B is the left child. Here B is the left child. Again B contains here D and E. So again you have to visit in the pre-order manner, that is left root node, left and right child. That is here left tree is D. We have to write on this here D. Next is E. You have to write the right child of the this here E. Next there is no right and left subtree of for the D and E node. So we have to go for the where left tree traversal is now completed. So we have to go for the right. That is C is the right subtree of the root node A. So but it again contains, we are already told that in the third step, that is right sub visit the right subtree in the pre-order manner. That is, in the pre-order manner means we have to again visit, that is left subtree, next that is F, next again right subtree, that is G. So now everything is completed. It means first we are traversal the root node, next left subtree, next again right subtree. This is the pre-order traversal, that is A, B, D, E, C, F, G. This is the upcoming pre-order traversal. Now we go through the in-order traversal. That is, in-order traversal means it contains left, root and right. It means we have to first visit the left child in in-order manner. Second is, we have to visit the root node. Next, we have to visit the right child in the in-order manner. Let us see this example. That is, here is an example, that is 3 nodes A, B, C. This is the root node, that is N. This is the left, this is the right. How we have to traversal here using in-order? It means first we have to visit the left child, that is left child here B, that is B. Next we have to visit the root node, that is root node here is A. Next right subtree, that is C. So the in order tree traversal for this example is BAC. Let us see another example, that is it contains 7 nodes, that is ABC, DE, FG. How we have to in order traversal, that is first C. Here we have to visit the left subtree, that is left subtree, we have to visit for the left subtree. That is B is the left subtree for A. Again D is the left subtree for B. So here D has no left subtree or right subtree. So we have to first traverse, that is D. Because it is the left subtree of the B, we have to traverse for the left subtree, that is D. Next, again we have to traverse, that is root node, that is B. B is the root node for this D. So again we have to traverse right, that is E. in order manner only we have to traverse using in order traversal. Now see here, already all left subtree is traversed, so now we have to visit the second step, is that is root node. Here root node is the A, we have to traverse, that is A. Next come to the right subtree. This is the left subtree, this is the right subtree. Here also we have to traverse in the in order manner only. That is, first we have to traverse the again left subtree, that is F, again root node, that is C, again right child, that is G. See, here now we have the traverse, that is in order traversal for this example is D, B, E, A, F, C, G. This is the in order traversal. Now it is the last tree traversal, that is post order traversal. Here post order traversal means first we have to visit for the left subtree in the post order manner only, and we have to visit the right subtree in post order manner only. Again the third process is we have to visit the right, that is L R N. We have to remember this. First is left, second is root, and second is right, last is root node. Here is an example, that is it consists three nodes, that is A, B, C. This is the root node, that is A, this is the left, this is the right. Here see, first we have to visit the left subtree, that is left subtree here is the B. B is the left subtree, and we have to visit the next, that is right subtree, that is C. Then again last is root node, that is A. That is BCA is the post order tree traversal for this example. Again we see the second example, it consists of seven nodes, that is A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Again we have to use the post order manner only. So first is the, this is the root node, next this is the left subtree, this is the right subtree. Here see, here first is left subtree, that is the, we have to visit the left subtree in the post order only, that is D is the left subtree of B, B is the left subtree of A. So we have to consider first D, that is D. Next we have to visit the right in the, that means we have to visit in the L or N in the post order manner only, that is right child, that is E. Again we have to visit the root node, that is B. Now here left subtree is already traversed. Then we have to go for the second step, that is right subtree. So we have to go for the second right subtree in the post order manner only. That is we have to reach the first left subtree, that is F. Next again right subtree, that is G, and again root node, that is C. Now here we completed the right subtree. Now it left only root, that is last is we have to visit the root node, that is A. Now we got the post order tree traversal, that is D, E, B, F, G, C, A. This is the tree traversal using post order for this example. I hope friends, you today discussed about the binary tree representation and tree traversal concepts. I hope you better understand. Thank you one and all. Thank you.